case?
You don't even know my case.
The Madison case? Nuisance suit happens to visitors all the time. Fact is, J.J. Madison doesn't really have a cat. He's allergic. I could have it thrown out in no time.
Wait, he never had a cat? So why is he gonna sue somebody for it?
Because he can.
What?
Every adult citizen of Morlock is a lawyer, so everybody sues everybody else. Doesn't matter if there's a cause. It's how we ensure everyone makes a living off their profession.
Yeah, but that's insane!
I could sue you for that. You just made a defamatory remark about this town. Hey, you're looking at my legs. I could sue you for that too. Sexual harassment.
Is there anything you can't sue me for?
Hire me. That way everything between us is subject to attorney-client privilege. I'm $75 an hour. First hour's free.
Well, at least you know my case. All right, you're hired.
Hey, I'm suing you, Valerie. No. For the sexual enticement or the appearance thereof of a potential client on a public thoroughfare. He only hired you because he found you sexually attractive.
Hurry, my office. We could get slapped with a dozen more lawsuits just walking down the street.
This'll be a cinch. Shouldn't take more than a couple weeks.
Couple weeks? No. I have to be in Denver on October 2nd. It can't take that long.
That's not long. Long is our city limit sign. We've been trying to get a new one put up for 5 years now. But we forgot to file an environmental impact report. And as the metal in the signpost is a potentially hazardous substance, we're in court over that. And another lawyer is challenging the census figure on the sign. And another lawyer said we had to do a new land survey to determine the exact city limits, so we'll know precisely where to put the sign. So we brought in a surveyor, but he got sued for smoking and was enjoined from finishing the survey. I'd say we're at least 2 years from a new sign.
And you choose to live here?
I wouldn't live anywhere else. Every day is a new challenge, a new precedent, a new way of interpreting the law. It's an intellectual feast.
Okay, so if everyone who lives here is a lawyer, how do you live? I mean, who runs the grocery store? Who does your dry cleaning? Who fixes the shitter when it breaks?
Well, we all moonlight on the law-related jobs. You know, police, bailiffs, court reporters. But those other trivial things you mentioned, they're done by people like you, awaiting trial. It's the only way they can afford their legal fees. Now, I can get you a hearing for Monday, October 1st. Meanwhile, we'll have to call witnesses to testify as to your character, you know, family, friends, so that you can qualify for your employment program. It'll help keep costs down. So tomorrow morning, why don't you get me their names and numbers, and I'll subpoena them.
Well, even if they could get here, wouldn't they get sued too?
Of course. But you'll indemnify them, and their problems will fall on your shoulders, which means more work for me.
Okay, well, I have those phone numbers. They're in my car. I'm gonna go get them, and I'm gonna make a few calls and be right back.
No, you won't. Fred, Mr. Oliver's a potential fugitive. Lock him up.
Lock me up?
Of course. We lawyers have to protect our livelihood.
Wait, you can't do this to me. I have rights.
I know you do, sweetie. I'm here to protect them. Tell the court how you know the defendant.
He was my employee.
And how would you characterize him?
Honest, trustworthy, intelligent.
Ask him if he's aware that the charge against me is a lie and that everyone here knows it.
It's immaterial. He can only testify as to character.
Just ask him.
The judge will rule it immaterial.
You ask him, or I'll fire you.
Mr. Cody, are you aware that the charge against Mr. Oliver is not only a complete lie, but that the judge, the plaintiff, and every citizen here know it?
Objection! Immaterial! It has nothing to do with the character of the accused.
Sustained.
Wait a minute, miss. You're saying this is a trumped-up charge, and you're all in on it?
Immaterial. The witness is ordered to ignore the question.
Well, I'm not going to ignore it, Your Honor. If what she says is true, it's a very serious matter.
Well, serious or not, it's immaterial to this hearing. Next question.
Whoa, Judge. I asked her a question, and I want an answer.
You don't ask the questions here, Mr. Cody. You answer them. And if you don't do what I tell you to do, I will hold you in contempt.
Hey, I'm not answering any more questions until somebody answers mine. Why don't you tell me, Judge, are you in on a lie here?
I fine you $500 for contempt.
Answer my goddamn question, Judge.
$1,000 and 90 days in jail. Bailiff, Sergeant, put Mr. Cody in a cell.
Whoa! Hold the phone, boys. This is dynamite. We'll all go. I'm terminally ill, and I'll gladly take you all with me to hell right now. Judge, I said stick your finger up your nose.
Show of hands. Now, how many here knew this thing was a railroad job against Mr. Oliver? Liars, lawyers. Mr. Oliver, how do we teach these liars a lesson?